If there's one thing I can brag about, it's that I have seen a lot of movies. You tend to do that as a film student. From Spy Kids 1 to Fahrenheit 451, The Last Jedi to The Last Airbender, there's just so many out there. And so many of them are bad. Now don't get me wrong, it's a miracle that any single film production goes through and that something comes out at the end. That's a goddamn miracle. Filmmaking, bitch. But sometimes, the sum total, the effect that your film has had on the world has just been a negative one. These are films that have everything wrong to do with the film industry, and just art in general. These are the 1 out of 10s on IMDb. These are the films I passionately hate. Well, with a passion. Oh, and don't expect any Twilights or Fast and the Furious, because although they're easy targets, they don't actually offend me. One Last Ride just isn't for me. But they still bring someone happiness. Quite a lot of people happiness. I also won't be calling out B-movies, because although the internet has this cute idea of what a bad movie is, they still add something. They're still adorable. Even the most desperate, pathetic piece of schlock can be itself charming. I'm not talking about these movies. These are movies that left such a bad feeling in my stomach. You are allowed to hate movies, just as much as people love movies. I hate these films with more passion than some wars. So, for starters, this list is probably about 10 years old now. So I think we have to discount all the ones I haven't actually seen. Goodbye, Junior. Okay. Beauty and the Beast is on here, just on a principle, I guess. And Les Mis. Like, for example, I know that musical masterpiece Les Mis is not a 1 out of 10. I just had an ex-girlfriend who wouldn't stop fucking watching it! So maybe that's not quite fair. Let's discount that one too. For some reason, back in 2012, I also had a problem with Pudsey the Dog, the movie. Never seen it. I wish I knew. I wish I knew why. But without any further ado, speed round. A Serbian film. Let's go for a spoiler warning, and a trigger warning, and a violence warning. Okay, go. The pitch. A retired porn star is brought in for one final job. A snuff film involving pedophilia and necrophilia. Yeah, that's what I like. Fuck this film. It's 104 minutes of deplorable, pretentious evil. Oh yeah, congrats. That's your addition to the world? This film has some very artsy things to say about filmmaking, and I hate it. This is film. No, it isn't. Some people shouldn't even be allowed film. Historically, it can be used for evil. And I honestly consider this an example of that. It's kind of obvious this film's greenlit just to spark controversy, and that is a pathetic motivation for making a film. Some have called this a dark masterpiece, and without being reductive, this film isn't about anything. Blatant torture porn for sociopaths. I honestly recommend it to nobody except sociopaths who might want to see a baby get fucked. But hey, if that's your thing, why don't you just dig out a real snuff film? Probably be less pretentious. Terrible movie, deplorable content, and an evil message about film in general. Fuck off. Jurassic World. Safe, soft reboot. The softest of reboots. On a property that I needed to be good. It's a very strange film to hate, but I lumber this one under the disappointment category. I just needed this film to be so much more. It was my film of the year, and it was beaten by fucking Minions. It's just a film indicative of regurgitation. Hey, remember this? Literally running through the dead corpse of a better film. And that's all there is here. Lots of remember that's and nostalgic cash grabs, a couple spiteful deaths, a complete lack of self-awareness when it comes to corporate franchising. That is the villain of the piece. And also, this weird nuclear family moral about putting family before work. Oh, you'll understand when you have kids someday, is code for, you are a broken woman. It's a cheap, nasty little product. And with a better director, who isn't a hack fraud, it could have really been something. Look Who's Back, a German-made comedy, The Pitch, Adolf Hitler awakes in Monday. Confused about the surroundings around him, he starts a social media account and people begin laughing at him. But then they begin listening to him. It's not actually a terrible premise. It makes a great, like, political satire. The novel it's actually based off of is fantastic and terrifying. Warning against just how easily someone can rock up and be laughed at and be accepted into media and politics. Remind you of anyone? It's a book with a social warning, but the adaptation is in two minds about this warning. And instead they go for cutesy Hitler. Hitler goes on a fun road trip, shoots a dog, holds a mouse funny, squandering that message entirely. Something you can't do when the topic is this sensitive. Congrats, movie, you're normalizing Hitler every bit as much as the people in the movie do. Oh, and the ending. Adolf Hitler gives a unifying speech about how neo-Nazism will never go away and will one day rise again. Which would be great, except this film has never actively out loud decried Nazism. The parody has failed because there will be tens or hundreds of waiting neo-Nazis accidentally inspired by a terrible bit of vague miss the point parody. People can be stupid. People can miss the point. What's so wrong with this Hitler guy anyway? I just spent 2 hours with him and he was a pretty funny guy. When Hitler is your underdog, you do not end the film with a vague motivational speech about Nazis. Not in this generation anyway. So when tens or hundreds of potential neo-Nazis are accidentally recruited through this, don't be surprised. What is this, some kind of Suicide Squad? Look, I was trying to stay away from superhero movies, okay? The fact that only one studio has so hugely missed the ball is testament to how well the genre is thriving. I've done a whole video on my instant reaction to Suicide Squad and...
Stop! It hurts! I miss movies! I miss cinematic experience!
Yeah, it was mostly shouting. But there is still a part of me that will never get over how intensely awful the editing, the writing, every single part of film that I've come to study and cherish, raped. Yeah, I went there. Everybody involved in this production just needs to get out of their contracts and run. Hey, it's almost like editing a film 3 times and then shoving it all together was a bad idea. Makes you think. But it does actually help you appreciate a miracle like the Avengers and shows you just how difficult it is to do. What do you think, Slipknot, the man who can climb anything? Oh no, Slipknot, the guy who can climb anything. The vampire's assistant. You don't even need a pitch for this one. You know when Harry Potter fans say that the movie wasn't as good as the original? Shut the fuck up. You guys got off lucky. Look what I grew up with. This is the movie adaptation of my childhood book series. And it's flaccid. It's a flaccid film. And with a young adult teen novel, you can go one of two ways. An industry-defining, putting a country on the map cultural icon, or the Nickelodeon movies route.
You need to get over this.
Shut the fuck up, okay? Really, this is a 3 out of 10, but it's just such a personal blow.
And it also means there will never be a fucking Cirque du Freak movie or a TV series. Why?
I mean, hey, Willem Dafoe and John C. Reilly are in it, and they're actually not half bad as weird freak casting.
But just look at this fucker right here. Look at him. Look at you, Josh.
Look what you did to my childhood franchise, Josh.
Epic movie!
Okay guys, maybe it was the alcohol? I actually had a lot of fun with Epic Movie.
Oh, don't get me wrong, it is a pathetic, parody example of why pop culture references and pop culture references alone will date your movie. And the parody movies are nothing but that. There's no content. There's no plot. There is nothing new other than shamelessly plugging things that you know into your face. These films basically just treat you like fucking idiots, but I think they do it to such a degree that they border on surreal. sit down and watch Epic Movie and try, just try, to follow the plot. Your brain will fucking implode. Then you begin to see just how little movie there is. Don't even watch this as a film. Watch it as a fucking artifact. I shit you not, there is a 10 minute long MTV Cribs joke. I don't even get what they're referencing. It's so fucking abstract and dated.
Ha, very nice. Is my wife.
Borat. Borat, that was a Borat joke. Remember them? Also, pencil in vampires suck for, you know, similar reasons. The weird 2000 and late bandwagon of Twilight hate was so vocal that it even allowed crap films like this to reach the public. Vampires Suck is exactly what you think it is. It's funny because you've targeted one film craze, whilst delivering a much more incompetent film. There's no self-awareness in any of these. But to its credit, Vampires Suck does have something resembling a joke. A punchline even. Honestly, a ridden bit of comedy that goes further than, haha, man fall down. Can I just put everything ever made by Adam Sandler on here? I'm aware that he has apparently made a couple good films, Don't Mess with the Zohan, The Wedding Singer. I don't even want to give him the benefit of the doubt. Any goodwill this comedian has generated has been depleted by becoming a hack fraud of Hollywood. Grown Ups 2 had a budget of $80 million. That's almost like half of Titanic. And me? I've never seen Grown Ups 2. I don't intend to. I don't want to give this fucker more money to go on holiday and bring some cameras along. My only question is, where did all the money go? It wasn't on the film. Trust me, this thing looks like a fucking Saturday Night Live sketch. That's my boy, Jack and Jill. Come and watch Adam Sandler and his unimaginative comedy friends go on holiday, because that's all this production was. His jokes also insult my intelligence and other cultures? But don't worry about that. Mr. Sandler looks like such a sad clown these days anyway, but I mean, we can't be too hard on him. Pixels was creepy, Jack and Jill was an insurance scam, and Click, well, I don't really know what Click was, but I didn't like it. Sausage Party! I love a bit of irreverent comedy, okay? I can deal with that, I'm not a triggered little cuck. I loved South Park when I was 12. I love adult animation. I even can admit that Seth Rogen has actually made funny films before. This isn't one of them. Sex jokes, drug jokes, and racist jokes is all this film has. Insulting. It's tacky, edgy, and desperate to be offensive. But it is also exploitative. So many animators got screwed over by this production. Unpaid overtime, and threatening to replace animators without crediting them. Now, Seth Rogen has a writing credit, which is interesting, because this entire premise is actually plagiarized from a short film. Bet you didn't know that. But that's fine, it's not as if animation is the hard part. No, all the money went to Seth Rogen and his lazy comedy friends, who just came into the studio and did some voices for 5 minutes. Hopefully all that money goes to a good cause. Like, more weed jokes, man! Fuck Seth Rogen. Things that actively try to be edgy are made for 14-year-olds. Pacific Rim. Okay, Sam. Bold choice. How are you going to lay waste to Guillermo del Toro? Recent Oscar winner and film fan favourite.
Oh, I didn't really like Pacific Rim very much.
Pacific Rim is a competently made waste of my fucking energy. Pacific Rim isn't one of the worst films ever made. I know that, but it is one of the most disappointing. A huge squandering of potential. Please, Hollywood, please do not ever give up on making a Gundam mecha movie. You can do it. I believe in you. The mechs are ugly. The lead, completely bland. The side cast, completely tonally jarring. And worst of all, America saves the day against all the fucking odds. I think this was my 17th birthday present. to myself, and I came out of the cinema pissed. Because every single thing about this film that works is not in the film itself. I know it's Hollywood, but this film was Rinko Kikuchi's. Her character, Idris Elba's, both characters' origins are more interesting than this plot. It's like a white savior trope, but with mechs. Holy shit, oh my god, an American hero defeating kaiju. How, that's so wrong in concept. Because America, you are the kaiju. Oh, this film is still such a sore spot. You just know when you have a new potential favourite film, and this could have and should have been my favourite film. But no, it made me hate Charlie Day. A film made me hate Charlie Day. I just wanna tell you all, go f*** yourself. The advertising campaign was the coolest fucking thing you've ever seen. Top Trump's stats of all the different nations, showing every single country and their adjacent mech. That's cheesy. I love it. But when we fight the apocalypse, there's only three mechs standing. China, Russia, and America. And even with an outdated mech and two new pilots, guess which country saves the world? It's annoying because the film clearly sets up a multinational alliance, and the trailers were basically false advertising. There's maybe 3 minutes of mechs that do not belong to America. It's only America who can save the day. In one of the least inspired American movies ever made. It is more Godzilla than Transformers, but I'm talking like Roland Emmerich Godzilla. I'm sorry, Guillermo. Please stick to your Oscar movies. Your comic book stuff? Nah. Death Proof. Sorry, Tarantino fans. Death Proof is trash. What a hot take. Tarantino clearly exhibiting his fetish with endangering young women in car crashes, which considering we found out is what he did to Uma Thurman back in Kill Bill, this film is likely an exploitative guilt reaction to that. Gross. And finally, my least favourite film in existence. Well, apart from German Nazi propaganda, Piranha 3DD. It's only marginally better than The Eternal Jew, okay? Piranha 3DD is not the worst made movie in the world. It really isn't. For what it is, it's very, very competent. At times, well shot. Big budget. But it is a movie that is completely irresponsible, deplorable, borderline evil. Look, this film wasn't intended to be looked at by film scholars. I know that. I went into it just wanting a good time, and I came out of it miserable and hating the human race. Mean-spirited nihilism is the quickest way to put me off a film. There's no greater meaning to it. It's no pastiche of like B-movie cinema. No. It's just mean, awful things happening, and you're meant to laugh at them. Oh, yeah, the ending.
Ava, get away from that thing! No, it's okay, you're slow on land.
Little ginger moron.
Now that's funny. Sleaze. This film is sleaze. Made by professionals who should know better. This isn't a B-movie, this is an industry who decided to make trash. To be trash. Oh! Is that Weinstein? Oh my god, that's hot! Now it all makes sense. And then there's Christopher Lloyd in it, and you're almost on the fun sort of parody side of Birdemic, but then a guy gets his penis chomped off. And that sounds a lot funnier than it actually is. Boom, that's a joke. Boom, that's a rap. I hate watched this movie out of fascination, out of shock, honestly. With B-movies, I get B-movies. I understand B-movies. But these are clearly career professionals who just should know better. Who are films like this made for? That's what I ask myself. This film is Date Rape, the movie. Honestly, because that's what it feels like. The bro-y sleaze of Date Rape. And that's not even because of a white... No, let's not go there. I hate being negative around film. I hate the negativity surrounding film culture. But sometimes you have got to put your foot down. Sometimes you've got to have values. And I don't even want to be able to get this film. I don't want to know or understand the guy who does get this film. Because that guy... I mean, that guy ain't me. And thank you for watching. This was a motherfucking beast of a video. Let me know your most hated movie in the comments below.